G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. Now, I can't believe I haven't done this figure. I've had this figure in my stash for a long time. So this one is your 135 scale Mantis Miniatures German SS Grenadier, Eastern Front, 1942 to 1943. I've seen this figure painted up a couple of times, and I just absolutely love the look of this figure. Probably a little bit different to a lot of other people out there. I'm probably not a big fan. I think, is that the flare gun he's got? It looks like a flare gun or something like that. I'm not exactly sure what, whatever it is, the pistol, whatever you want to call it, he's got in his hand. I think it's a flare gun, but I'm probably inclined to actually change the hands out. And I was thinking about probably just having him either eating something or maybe looking at a map, tilting his head down, looking at this hand here and reading a map or something like that, and maybe having something else in his other hand. I think I've bought one or two of these figures because I really liked it. Number 35010, if you're looking for it. And I know it's done by Mantis Miniatures, but I actually think Mantis Miniatures, I don't know why I keep on saying Mantis, Mantis Miniatures, but I think it may have been sold under another brand as well. I'm trying to think of the name of it, but I think it was sold under one or two different brands, this figure. If you know, leave a comment down below. Really love the look of this one. I love my Germans in winter gear. I'm not a fan of just normally the plain Jane, you know, non-winter uniforms, but I really love when they've got a couple of different layers on them. I can't tell you why, but that's just me. Let's have a look inside. So here are all the parts laid out here. And one thing I really did like about this figure, if you're someone who just wants to get into painting straight away and not having to muck around too much, you can pretty much get in with this one, given that the arms are attached, and pretty much just start painting the whole uniform straight away. It's very quick if you're wanting to get straight into the painting, quick priming, and you're pretty much on your way. Let's have a little bit of a close-up of the parts. So here's the main body part, and I've got to say, this is probably as close as to an Alpine Miniatures figure I think you're going to get from a different company. It's a quite a clean cast. A little bit of tidying up. You can just see just a little bit here. Just there. But other than that, and maybe just a tiny bit, but not much at all in the way of cleanup. There aren't any really, really nasty casting lines. And I think I might have picked this figure up, and because I liked it, I pretty much went and picked another one up. If you like your figures, sometimes it can be really annoying when you like a figure and you don't pick it up straight away. And then later on, could even be a year or two down the track, you find out that it's been discontinued. Which is why I think this might have been under a couple of different brands, because I think when I did try and pick it up again, I couldn't get it under the brand I'd picked my former one up on. So I picked this one up under a different name. It wasn't a recast, it was just, if I can think of the name, I think that's right, unless I'm getting confused with another figure, or if it was in a different packaging. I think, if memory serves me correct, it might have been in a bit of a silver packaging with red writing, the last one I picked up. I really like all the holes in the straps. Just a couple of little bits of just blobs almost of resin that you might just need to cut off, but other than that, you know you don't have a really nasty casting line that you really have to go and, you know, putty up all the way up the figure or tidy up. Just a little bit of flash here and there, but the straps and everything are done really well. And as you know, I do like my creases and folds, especially 135 scale. I mean, this is pretty amazing for 135 scale. As I always say, I'm getting very spoilt. And this figure's, I mean, I could be exaggerating, but this figure's like 5 or 10 years old now. So, you know, pretty impressive, given that was done a long time ago. Well, not a long, long time ago, but you know what I mean. And the boots have some nice texture on them as well. I think at the moment I was thinking about maybe having, you know, you could have a rifle in this hand if you liked. Looking at a map or whatever, even have his, put his, you know, grab another Alpine Miniatures figure or Evolution Miniatures figures and change the hands over. Got a bit of a which is a bit of a hate of mine, big casting block on the top of the helmet. I much prefer it on the bottom of the neck here. But what I will say about this is I think he's got a really nice face, this guy. Hopefully it'll show up for you, but really, really nice face. For 135 scale, one of the nicest faces that I've seen in this scale. And one or two air bubbles, I think, on the helmet there, as you can see. But, you know, that's pretty easy to fill up that part. Probably just cutting this off. And maybe filling that up a little bit. Looks like there could be a little bit of a dent in there that you might need to fill up as well. But really nice face in this scale. Sit in there for you. There's a lot going on with this figure with all the magazine pouches and the binoculars and the straps, everything, the other straps coming down. Very busy figure. Just quickly, just his knife and entrenching tool there. I do like when they have the straps that come over and you can see the little holes in the straps and the tie down. That's pretty nice. Same with this one, as I always say, with the wire, a little bit of a clean up in the canteen there to get rid of the flash in between the wire, but at least the wire is all there. If you watch some of my other videos, you can see that sometimes when this is casted, it doesn't all sort of turn out the way it's supposed to. Looks a bit, maybe a little bit out of shape there, just a tad. But it's probably not as tidy as I'd like. The actual water bottle, if you like, that's done pretty well. We can't complain about that. And geez, I tell you what, these manufacturers and the way they're getting with their weapons now. I mean, some of these things are amazing. Like, if you go back to some of the old 1/9 scale figures, they weren't sculpted and cast as neat as these things. I mean, for 135 scale, this is a really nice... cast. There could just be a little bit of an air bubble in the barrel there. You can sort of see it up the top here, just a tiny one. But I mean, the rest of it, like for resin, it's done exceptionally well. And then you get your little stock here, and sometimes with these stocks, this one doesn't look too bad, but if they don't turn out the way you want them to, I just jump into one of the Dragon sets or Gen 2 set and grab one of the stocks from there and whack them on the weapon. Or if you're not happy with the whole thing, you know, just grab one from one of the Dragon Gen 2 sets or something like that. And then last up, you've got his hands here. And they're done pretty well. I'd say some, if I was really picky, some of the hands looked a little bit just, how would you say, just rectangle in shape, the fingers. More than a bit of a rounded thing, and that's being really, really picky, but I don't know if you can sort of see it there a little bit. It just looks like they're like long little rectangles, if you like, all shaped, you know, exactly the same, like they've just had a piece of putty and cut, put a knife through it, but that's being really picky. But the other side here, you can sort of see it on this side as well. Hopefully you can see what I'm sort of talking about, but I mean, we're talking 135 scale, guys, but you know, I do like to highlight things that I sort of see when I'm looking at it. Not saying that, you know, I couldn't sculpt anywhere near this. I couldn't even sculpt a hand, but, you know, if you're thinking about buying these figures, and especially if you think about what I'm doing, swapping the hands out with other hands, or putting these hands on something else, maybe on another figure, you know, you might be interested to know that. There you have it, guys. That was just a very quick one on the Mantis Miniatures German SS Grenadier Eastern Front 1942-1943. 135 scale. And I actually really like this figure. I rate it highly. As I've said, when I picked one up, I went out and bought the same figure again because I actually really like the look of it. And apart from probably, you know, but this is just pretty standard these sometimes, is having the casting block on the helmet. And probably just, other than that, I really don't really have much to complain about. Probably you could change the little equipment out here for some plastic stuff. And maybe, you know, I do like the entrenching tool, but I don't think, you know, like, I'm being really fussy, but you could find possibly a better one as well if you were doing just I'm talking about if you're just doing a single standalone figure. If you were thinking about putting that in a competition or something like that, I'd probably change some of that equipment out. But the weapon itself's really nice, and like you said, if the stock turns out okay, that'll be fine. But if you have problems with it, you can always replace that with something else. But all in all, I actually really like this figure. I think it's a cracker, and if you pick it up, you definitely won't be disappointed with it. As always, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.